Sometimes it can seem so overwhelming when we talk about this, but always wanting to take that step back and say, okay, what are the steps that we as families and parents can take right now to start to have an impact on that body burden for ourselves and our children? So as you're looking at that, what would you say are the first key steps that we should be taking?
I want to frame this in two ways. What can we do in the short term, and what must we do in the long term? In the long term, it's critical for us to demand that our public health agencies, our regulatory agencies, make sure that we're not being exposed to toxic chemicals in the first place. And I say that because I do this for a living, and I can only do so much to protect my family, right? So it's not that we lack the expertise, it's that the chemicals are just so widespread, and we're tackling them one at a time in terms of our research, right, in terms of our advocacy efforts oftentimes too. So that's gotta be the ultimate goal. In the interim, in the meantime, what can each of us do in our own homes? There's actually quite a few things that can help reduce exposures, and I'd start out with what we eat and the food that we prepare. So we know that organic food tends to have lower residues of pesticides or lower contamination with pesticides. It's not going to be foolproof, but it's definitely much lower. We also have some early evidence that it's more nutritious and it's better for the soil. And again, it's not essential for us to feed the world to rely on these pesticides. So organic is a good place to start. Trying to avoid packaging and heavily processed food, which will oftentimes introduce things like phthalates. These are chemicals that are oftentimes associated with plastics and vinyl. They are anti-androgens. They lower testosterone. That's not a good thing. And, we were talking about this replacement of one chemical with another. That's clearly happened with phthalates, where early on some phthalates were identified to be toxic. They were voluntarily taken off the market and replaced with other phthalates that were later shown to be toxic and have similar types of toxicity. So this idea of constantly replacing one chemical with another similar one that hasn't been studied yet and therefore hasn't been proven toxic really has to stop. The other one, big one for food, is bisphenol A. And even though, you know, we all thought we did a great thing by stopping using water bottles with BPA, they did in fact, in some cases, replace them with other types of BP chemicals that are just as bad. But they're also oftentimes found in canned foods today. And so what we've done in our household, in addition to moving away from canned foods, we have almost no canned foods in our house. We make most of our food from scratch. Beans was a hard one, right? Getting beans when we don't use canned foods, but now the Instant Pot allows us to make beans pretty quickly, and so no canned foods. Tomato sauce was another hard one, but you can get it in bottles, and so we've moved to that. And we're not overzealous about it. We do what we can. We go out to a restaurant, we don't demand that they feed us organic food, but we do what we can, particularly in our household, to minimize exposures, and then we go on, you know, about just living our life. The other thing is, and this has happened with groups like Non-Toxic Neighborhoods out of Irvine, California. They've been working with communities around the country and even now the world to eliminate pesticide use on playgrounds, in schools, sports fields, even along highways, because they're unnecessary. Those are cosmetic, and there are alternatives, right? Growing native plants along highways is much better than using glyphosate. And they've been wildly successful. We have a number of provinces up here that don't allow pesticides for cosmetic use. And, you know, those have been linked with IQ deficits in kids, ADHD in children, and even childhood leukemia. And so these are low-hanging fruit. Get rid of the pesticides around your house. I've also tried to encourage my children. I have three children, they're all daughters, not to use cosmetics lotions and fingernail polish, for example. It was really hard, particularly when they were adolescents, because of course they're bombarded with these billboards and advertisements that say, if you don't use these products, you're not beautiful, which of course is just crap. But you know, that's the message. It was hard, but now in their 20s, two of the three use very little and one's very conscientious about what she uses. But you know, every parent still has to go through this process. That's the problem.